Stay tuned for Indiana's best newscast, next on Channel 8. From Wish TV in Indianapolis, Mike Ahern, Debby Knox, Weather with Stan Wood, and Sports with Jim Barber. This is News 8.
Valentine's Day 1989, and this is what it's all about. You're looking at a live-eye picture from the City County Building downtown, where in just a few minutes now, Alice Ives and Robert Collins will take their wedding vows, a wedding that we will witness live. Good evening, it's 5:30, and shortly we'll be joining Alice and Robert as they join in matrimony.
But first, let's take a quick look around to see how Valentine's Day was celebrated in central Indiana. As Athelmica and photographer Carl Fincham discovered, there were the familiar rituals of this day and some that were a bit unusual. Here's a sampling. Yes, sir.
Hendricks, I got several warrants here. I want you to know they're drawn up by Judge Philip R. Good. Are you familiar with him?
No, sir, I'm not.
They call him Judge Feelgood downtown. You'll be familiar with him before the day's over.
Yes, Mrs. Price. This is Philip at the 240 desk. I have some flowers for you.
I've made a lot, but we're very busy.
What?
There you go.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Well, thanks, but who's this?
If you can inflate this, we know that you're not on drugs or anything else, because if you can inflate this after you inflate it, if you're still standing, you're a darn good person. I can say that for you, Hendricks.
My name is Jeff. I'm 28 years old, and I'm in real estate development.
Jeff, how long have you been in the real estate business?
In the real estate business, Charles, for about 4 years.
There you go, Hendricks. Good job. I want you to know that that's what Gary says you look like every time you nag at him.
Comfortable first date, I would go to dinner, drinks, maybe some dancing.
Tell us what your hot item is and describe it for us.
This is one of them. This is the Chippendale Bear. Notice he looks just as good as the Chippendale here. And he dresses as well, too.
Everybody seems to have the love spirit today.
Thank you.
You have a nice day.
Bye-bye.
Who's the balloon for?
My mother. It's her birthday.
Edible underwear, otherwise known as gourmet underwear. Basically, it's just a licorice smashed out.
I'll give you a kiss on this cheek right here, okay?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
I was sure you've guessed this already, but just for the record, that was not a city policeman. He is one of the performers for Merry Madness, making a delivery today.
Good name for that. Well, now for the more traditional sign of Valentine's Day, let's join Ethel live at the City County Building. Ethel, we're looking forward to this, too.
Yes, well, you know, love is what today is all about, and what better ultimate expression of love than to get married. And Alice and Robert have known each other for the last 20 years. Others have come in and out of their lives, but they finally realized that they were meant to be married, and they are going to do that in just a moment. And Judge Tom Barnes is performing the ceremony.
Robert, Alice. We're gathered here on this Valentine's Day to join Robert and Alice in marriage. Robert, repeat after me. I, Robert, take thee, Alice.
I, Robert, take thee, Alice.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and behold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
Richer and for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Love and to cherish.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
I, Alice, take thee, Robert.
I, Alice, take thee, Robert.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For the rest of my life.
For the rest of my life.
Robert, if you'll take the ring and place it on her left ring finger. Repeat after me. As a token of my pledge.
As a token of my pledge.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
By the power vested in me by the state of Indiana, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss. I present Mr. and Mrs. Robert Collins.
Congratulations. And I should mention that their friends, who are also stood up for them today, convinced them to get married on Valentine's Day, and now I am sure this is a wedding day that they will never, ever forget. Mike and Debbie?
KFL, thank you. Pass our congratulations on to them as well.
Congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Thank Collins. Well, in Las Vegas today, 500 weddings were scheduled, and in Philadelphia, Judge Bernard Goodhart continued his annual tradition of marrying sweethearts at City Hall for free. Couples line up outside his chambers every year to have Goodhart preside over their nuptials, and this year is no different. Before the day is over, the judge will have joined 35 couples in matrimony.
Well, the news this evening now. The first in a new series of American satellites is in outer space tonight. It was launched this afternoon. A $30 million Delta II rocket finally got off the ground after a two-day wait. NASA says unfavorable winds forced the delays. Skies were clear today, so the space agency was able to begin placing new navigational satellites in orbit. The satellite launched today is one of 18 that will be used by the military. Together, they'll enable our troops to determine their location and altitude within 53 feet of anywhere on Earth. Spring-like storms are causing major floods in portions of Tennessee. In one town outside Nashville, a 4-foot wall of water trapped dozens of families in their homes, also sweeping away trucks that were on rescue missions. By noon, everyone was believed to have been saved. However, one motorist who ignored police warnings drove her car into the racing water. The creek carried the woman away as police tried to reach her. 71 patients from a local hospital had to be evacuated by National Guard troops. 5 inches of rain fell overnight. Forecasters are warning of the possibility of more flash flooding throughout the evening. Once again, that was outside Nashville, Tennessee. We had some heavy rains down in the southern part of this state.
Mm-hmm. Last night and early this morning. Cupid didn't need his umbrella around here, though, today. Turned out pretty nice right now. A nice afternoon going for us, but it is cloudy now. Those clouds are going to continue to thicken through the evening. Our temperature, a very spring-like 42 degrees. The dew point down at 31, but that will rise. Relative humidity at 65%. Our wind is from the northeast at 10 miles per hour. We have falling barometric pressure, 30.28 inches of mercury. Weathermaker today, well, high pressure sitting over the Hawkeye State. That'll move rapidly eastward across northern Indiana tonight, keeping the cool air up there. And that frontal system to the south of us will throw moisture in here, so we'll have rain beginning probably by 10 o'clock tonight locally. Further to the north, it'll be a freezing situation, so be alert to that as you drive up towards Chicago. My shortcast for tonight, though, thickening clouds and rain by about 10 o'clock tonight. Our overnight low will drop to 36 degrees, so no freezing problems here. Our wind will be from the northeast at 10 miles per hour. The rain was a little delayed, but it's on the way.
Okay, Stan, thank you. Still coming on News 8 at 5:30, the latest on whether Oliver North will ever stand trial in the Iran-Contra case.
And a comprehensive report card on the state of American education has been released.
A government plan to protect secrets in the trial of Oliver North was rejected today by Judge Gerhard Gesell. The Justice Department tried to intervene in the trial, saying national security might be compromised. But today, the judge told the Justice Department to stay out of the prosecution in the case. North's attorneys had said that accepting that agreement would have severely damaged their case. The proceedings are now delayed until at least Friday, so the Supreme Court can consider Gesell's motion.
A court battle involving one of the world's worst industrial accidents has come to an end. Union Carbide and the government of India have reached a settlement in the 1984 gas leak at a Union Carbide plant, which killed more than 3,000 people. Under the agreement, the American company will pay $470 million to the Indian government. The money will go to some 500,000 people affected by that disaster. India had wanted $3 billion from Union Carbide, but its lawsuit had been bogged down in the courts. The nation's public schools were handed a report card today, and their grades ranged from A to F. A yearly study commissioned by Congress says schools are teaching kids the basics, but they're not showing them how to use their knowledge. Our education reporter Leslie Olson has the story.
This is the Arsenal Technical Magnet School. The brightest kids from all Indianapolis high schools come here to take advanced science, math, and foreign language classes. This special school was recently opened, say IPS officials, because a serious problem was developing. Kids were mastering the basics from their textbooks, but they couldn't apply what they had learned. That, too, is the conclusion of today's national report card.
I'd say the report's probably very accurate. We find out that they can't use hammers, they can't use scissors, they can't use screwdrivers, much less use a piece of electronic equipment. They're great on computers. They can sit down there and hack on computers all day long.
Even these kids admit putting together a robotics project is a lot tougher than explaining how a robot works.
We were always in advanced programs, all of us here, but this is a more hands-on type of program, in this class especially. Taught how to, with use of science fairs and research projects, we're taught how to use the skills they've taught us in these classes.
Along with hands-on classroom experience, these magnet students will also go out into the community soon to work with professionals in fields of their choice, such as medicine. The students here also earn college credits. By the time some of these students have graduated from high school, they will have earned 45 college hours. That amounts to more than a year of college. But as much as these students seem to enjoy studying, even they booed the National Studies recommendation today to all teachers: assign more homework, tighten standards, toughen tests, and demand more. Leslie Olson, Wish TV, News 8.
The National Report Card Survey was based on data from more than 1 million students. Overall, its authors say the nation's schools are showing substantial improvement from the early 1980s. Well, coming up, would you know the symptoms of emphysema or cancer of the lung? We'll have the answer in part two of our series on your lungs. In health news now, the pulmonary function screenings are underway. Today's was held at the Castleton Mall, tomorrow at the Hyatt, and Thursday at the Greenwood Park Mall. We'll have more on that in just a moment. The question now is, do you know the symptoms for something like emphysema, chronic bronchitis, or cancer? Well, you can find out tonight.
If you had pneumonia, you'd most likely have a fever, rapid breathing, shaking, and severe chest pain. Bronchitis, a persistent cough. Emphysema, breathlessness, fatigue, weight loss. Asthma, wheezing and shortness of breath, coughing. And cancer, well, sometimes there are no symptoms. Other times, patients cough up blood. That's what happened to this man, Hugh McCabe. In an extraordinary documentary of this high school coach who died of lung cancer, he is point blank about the cause of his disease.
Because of my smoking, I have approximately 4 weeks, maybe 8 weeks, left to live.
In fact, most doctors agree that smoking is the common denominator in many lung problems like cancer, emphysema, and chronic bronchitis. And there's even more bad news for women. It seems that the deaths from lung cancer are surpassing those from breast cancer.
Women seem to have more difficulty stopping smoking than do men. One wonders if smoking-related diseases, which have traditionally been men's diseases, will be women's diseases 20 years from now.
Now for the good news. Lasers are being used more and more to cut out tumors in the lung. Radiation therapy has become more aggressive, with the radioactive material being placed right in the lung, killing tumors. As for asthma, well, there are new inhalants with fewer side effects that relieve symptoms. So what can you do to keep your lungs healthy?
It's really a matter of avoidance. Avoiding cigarette smoking, both the primary exposure and other people's cigarette smoke insofar as that's possible. And looking very closely at occupational lung exposures.
Your lung, a remarkably resilient organ when it's not abused, and the best thing you can do for it is not to smoke.
The screenings are held between 10 and 4 o'clock every day, and they're free. And by the way, we have some information for you. Preliminary results we're sharing now with from the pulmonary function test. Today out at Castleton Mall, close to 400 people took the free pulmonary function test. And close to 100 people learned that they should consult their physician about their lungs. That's 1 in 4, about 25%. The American Lung Association says the lines were steady most of the day, and because of that, they're going to have more respiratory therapists at the Hyatt tomorrow and the Greenwood Park Mall on Thursday.
Every year, more than 650,000 American women have a hysterectomy. That makes it the second most common major surgery for women, right behind cesarean sections. Whenever any surgery is done, there's always going to be a question about whether the operation is really necessary. Well, tonight, in part two of our special series, the story of a New Jersey woman who wishes she knew the facts.
There is fear etched on Judy Baker's face as she's escorted into the operating room. In just a few minutes, Judy will have an operation that could result in her having to have a hysterectomy. Growths in her uterus keep her from having another baby, something she desperately wants. A hysterectomy would end her hopes forever. But if Judy does need the hysterectomy, she'll become one of more than 650,000 women who will have the procedure done this year.
Hysterectomies fall into two categories as far as I'm concerned. They're the kind that are life-threatening, and the woman has a life-threatening disease. She must have a hysterectomy. She's bleeding to death. She's got cancer.
The other category is the so-called optional or elective hysterectomy. Those are done for a variety of reasons, including severe pain and or vaginal bleeding, which can be due to fibroids growing in the uterus, infections, and a condition called endometriosis. These problems are rarely life-threatening, but they can make a woman's life so miserable that she may opt for a hysterectomy. Experts say that it may be possible to avoid many of those elective hysterectomies, but that it takes an informed and dedicated woman to have the patience to keep trying different therapies while she's in pain or bleeding.
How willing are you to find out and to discuss and to have her understand what are the pitfalls, what are the advantages, and to have a very candid sort of discussion with that patient.
And the other type would be removing the uterus entirely, and that's a hysterectomy.
Despite the large number of hysterectomies performed, experts say women have a startling lack of knowledge about exactly what that operation involves. So here's what every woman should know before consenting to a hysterectomy. A woman's reproductive organs are found in the pelvis, close to the bladder and rectum. They consist of the uterus or womb, the fallopian tubes, the vagina, and the ovaries, which produce the critical female hormone, estrogen. A hysterectomy is actually the removal of just the uterus. A total hysterectomy removes the entire uterus, including cervix, but spares the tubes and, more importantly, the ovaries. The most radical surgery is often mistakenly referred to as a total hysterectomy because, in addition to the uterus, both the tubes and ovaries are also removed.
And tomorrow we'll conclude this series with a story of one woman who proved her doctors wrong.
Taking a look now at our follow-up file, a basketball coach with AIDS will be allowed to continue coaching. 37-year-old Alan Ward contracted AIDS from a blood transfusion. He's a volunteer coach for a grade school team in Franklin County. Last month, he was asked to leave the team while the school board decided whether to let him remain as a coach. Well, he was reinstated a few days later without a ruling from the board. Well, now the board has voted. It was 6-0 in favor of keeping Coach Ward.
And coming up this evening, Patty has an update on Indiana rocker Henry Lee Summer. You'll find out why he hasn't been in concert locally lately after this. There's Patty, and I didn't know that he had done not the soundtrack for the whole movie Twins, but a song from it.
A song from Twins,
I didn't know that. That's great.
Iron Eagle, too. He says that was okay, but he doesn't want to do that. He don't want to make a career out of that like Kenny Loggins. He'd like to perform, and he hasn't been performing lately. A year later, we find Henry Lee Summer going crazy. CBS Records has suggested that he not perform in concert locally until after his new album is released in April in order to make his next appearance on stage special.
Entire life, this has been one of the hardest things I've ever done, because since I was 15, 16 years old, I've played music every week. I mean, a lot of times in my younger days, 6-7 nights every week for years. And in recent years, at least four or five times a week. October 2nd until now, except for a couple of shows during the holidays, I've not played. I mean, and it's been real hard. I've gained 25 pounds. Which I'm so anorexic anyway, it doesn't matter. But
it looks good on you.
But well, thank you. But anyway, it's just like there's something missing, because I'm like wanting to. That's how I get everything out.
After the success of I Wish I Had a Girl, Henry Lee toured the country last year, supporting groups like Chicago and Cheap Trick and John Cougar Mellencamp. But has success spoiled Henry Lee?
I got to buy a new studio right here in my house. I put a new 24-track studio in. That was like a big dream I've had for years and years.
When everything's getting me down, oh yeah, you seem to all be around.
It's a lot easier for me for people just to go, hey, Henry, what's happening? As opposed to, look, there's Henry Lee Summer. He's getting out of a limousine. You know, he must really be think he's big time now or something. And then so it brings up a wall. That's the whole idea of everything I do, whether it's in concert or just walking down the street, is to like tear down all those walls and go, it's just me. It's just all, I sing music for a living, but I'm just like you are.
Can you walk down the street now? Do people bother you? You're very
they
recognizable.
Don't bother. They say
no.
Hello, or
So they'll either, it's either with me, it's either like, yeah, Henry, rock on, brother. Or it's like, hey, Henry, your music. You know, it's either great, either like it a lot, or it's like, yeah, Metallica rules. Well, that's all right. I just smile, wave, no matter what it's like. Yeah, right on, rock on, yeah. Yes.
Henry,
Metallica
cheer up.
Rules.
Cheer up. His new record is due out in April, and so he will get to perform finally in May.
No earring for him.
No, I asked him. I said, are you ever going to get an earring like one of those big rock stars? And he goes, I'm from Brazil, Indiana. I could not go home with an earring. So no great. Earring. Yeah.
Okay, thanks, Fanny.
Thank you.
Coming up on News 8 at 6 o'clock now, Debbie and I will have these stories for you. More charges against a Madison County doctor tonight, this time involving sex for drugs. We'll hear the accusations of an Anderson family.
A piece of bridge history in Rush County has burned and arson is suspected. I'm Neil Moore. That story is coming up on News 8.
Also tonight, we'll tell you about a move in the legislature to prevent any more 50-50 splits.
In sports, the Philadelphia 76ers speak out, sometimes spontaneously, on the plight of the Pacers.
And Stan will have the forecast.
Those stories and more coming next on News 8 at 6 o'clock.